So one of the big challenges when we're working with form fields is that as you add form fields, they are not tagged. And this is a huge fundamental problem, okay? The issue we run into is that you're going to get an error on every single form field that you create. So I'm going to show you how to fix that. There's a command in the tags pane called find unmarked annotations. And this allows you to tag all those form fields appropriately, but there's a trick, and I'm going to show that to you when we get there. You want to make sure that it doesn't really matter what order you create the form fields, but you want to make sure that you adjust the reading order of those form fields after the fact so that they're in the correct order. And then you want to double check your tab order in the document as well. All right. So I'm going to do a demo of this. And I don't think I have too many more slides. I'm going to do a demo of reading a form using a screen reader so you guys kind of understand the importance of that. And so what I'm going to do in your sample files that you downloaded for this class, I have a file called formfinishdd.pdf. And I'm just going to open that inside of Adobe Acrobat to get started. And I wanted to show you guys a demo of how a user reads a form using a screen reader. Okay, so I'm going to use NVDA, although the experience with JAWS is very, very similar.
Welcome to NVDA. Use start show OK button. Registration Adobe Acrobat.
Is everybody hearing that voice? Okay, cool. So let me give
heading
it there.
Heading
level
go. One, page one.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start reading this form.
Contact information. Oops. Heading left. Personal information heading level one.
Okay. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to read the next item in the form.
First name.
Okay, so it reads the label.
Enter legal first name here, edit.
And so now you're hearing the tooltip of the form field, right? I'll read the next one.
Last name. Enter your legal last name, edit.
So enter your legal last name is the tooltip. And as a general recommendation, it's encouraged to eliminate brevity in the tooltip. Like you don't have to say, please enter your legal last name. You just say, enter your last name, enter this, enter that. Whatever you want the user to put in that form field, that's what you want them to enter. Okay. Now, NVDA and JAWS both have what's called a form mode. Okay. And I'm going to switch over to that mode. Okay. Now, in form mode, it's only going to jump to each form field. Okay. It's not going to read the label. So now I simply have to hit the tab key.
Enter legal first name here, edit blank. Enter your legal last name, edit blank. Enter your email address, edit blank. Choose your registration type, combo box collapsed.
So do you see how it's ignoring all the other elements in the document? And now it's only reading the form fields. So those are the two ways that a user can read a form. Okay. I'm going to switch back over here. All right, guys. Well, I think that concludes our webinar for today. I hope you guys learned a lot. I hope you got answers to your questions and you now feel more comfortable, you know, creating accessible PDF, accessible fillable forms on your own.